Welcome to IELTS Band Up, where IELTS is made easy. Hello everybody, this is the first lesson in my grammar series to help you get a band 7 to 9 on your next IELTS test. Every time a noun is used, you must decide if an article is necessary. If it is necessary, well, which one? A, an, the, or maybe no article? You have to make the choice depending on meaning, shared knowledge, context, and whether the noun is singular or plural. And of course, I will go into much more detail of what this means in this lesson, but this is the introduction for what's necessary when choosing or not choosing an article. Especially if your first language is not a European one, articles will be very challenging. A lot of Asian languages, there's no articles. So these are very tricky, especially for new learners. You need to start with the basic rules, which of course I'll start with in this lesson, and add more knowledge as your English improves. Articles are not a lesson to be learned once. You should always be learning them with new nouns. I'll give you some examples later, but you will get better as time goes by. As you see the language more, it will become more natural. But this video is designed to make you aware and to help you, you know, improve your ability to notice them and use them better when you're writing and speaking. Well, let's talk about what articles are. Well, in grammatical terms, they're a kind of determiner. These are words that go before a noun, which come before a noun or noun phrase. And one simple rule you can remember is they show quantity. So a or an equals one. If you remember that one rule, that will help you a lot. That's step one in understanding, you know, what articles are. You also must remember that articles come before adjectives and adjective nouns. So the example I put here is, I saw a big white cat. Many times people just study I saw a cat, but if there's two, three, four adjectives before, the a comes before that. So I saw a big white cat. That's one example. I like the new intelligent teacher. So whether it's a or the, it's adjective, maybe two, maybe three, plus the noun. Articles show familiarity. This means between the speaker and the listener, or the writer and the reader. It's showing that both people know what is being talked about. Here's the example with the, okay? The restaurant next to our school. So the speaker and the listener know exactly which restaurant is being referred to. They both know it, so that's why they would say the restaurant, and it's showing that both of them understand. And opposite to this, articles show unfamiliarity. You know, these are called indefinite articles. This would be a or an. I saw a new restaurant on my way to school. Now, only the speaker knows about the restaurant, and this is something new to the listener. And that's why I really want to emphasize I saw a new restaurant. It's new for the speaker, and it's completely new to the listener. And there's one restaurant, so a. And again, it's used to show that it's something new, and it's something like that only one person knows, or maybe neither know. So here's a little learning tip. When learning new nouns, if the noun is countable, put a or an in front of it. You want your understanding to be automatic. So if you're a basic learner of English and you're learning a cat, well then write down a cat. But as your English gets, you know, more advanced and you learn the word benefit and you're wondering, well, is benefit countable or uncountable? Well, check your dictionary and it will say countable. And then you write in your, you know, vocabulary journal, a benefit. And you just always say that, a benefit. And it just becomes natural, okay? We do this in French and English, you know, like you put the male or un in front of a noun and then you just study it that way. Do the same thing with articles. Tip two, a or an are not pronounced clearly. I don't say a cat, I say a cat, okay? I don't say an eraser, I say an eraser. That's why they're a little bit difficult to notice when you're listening, because native speakers don't stress them. And that's why, you know, it can be harder to catch. And when you're pronouncing them too, just a cat, an eraser, don't stress them. Well, let's move on to talk about how we choose articles. Well, let's talk about when we don't need articles. Well, plural nouns. If it's, you know, two, three, four, cats can be big or small. So no article there. Uncountable nouns, I need money. And this goes back to what I said before. If it's countable in your vocabulary dictionary, put a cat. And if it's money, then there's no a. So that way it'll help you remember naturally which nouns are countable, which are not countable. Now there are times when we don't need an article before a singular noun and use another determiner. So it is singular, so you think, oh, I should use a. Well, here we go. Possessive adjectives. You know, there's one book, but, you know, she is the owner. So we would say her book, my pens, their father. So again, when we know who the owner is, we don't use an article. An article is when there's nobody who owns it, okay? Or you don't know who owns it. So if there's a book on the floor, well, there's a book on the floor. And somebody says, oh, that's my book. Well, then it's, you know, there's the owner. It's my book, or it's his book, or her book. So that's a key thing to remember. Is when we don't know who possesses or who owns the thing. Now, demonstrative adjectives, well, again, grammatical word, but they show quantity or location. It could be that book or those books. We never say that book. Oh, it's that book, this book, those books, this thing. So there's no before those kind of demonstrative adjectives and other quantifiers. And again, a grammatical word for any day, each day, one day. There's no before these words. Okay, well now let's move on to some basic rules to help you better use articles. This will go into a little bit more detail. The first part was kind of the basic rules. This is going into a little bit more detail, and it might make you a little frustrated, but they are things you need to know. Now we use a and an to introduce something new. So we use a and an with singular nouns to introduce something that is not common knowledge or something new. So we talked about this earlier, but it's good to repeat it. I learned a new expression. Again, this is something new, and it's one. We also use or un to introduce something new or unexpected. So you're telling a story, and you say, suddenly, I heard a noise downstairs. Again, it's the first time I mention it. It's something maybe surprising or something new. And again, a noise, it's countable. So we say, I heard a noise downstairs. Okay, so that's why we also might use it. Now here's a little example of how we start with a or an, and then it turns into the, okay? And again, this will emphasize the something new to the listener or reader. So I'll read it slowly. I was walking to school when I saw a cat. The cat, okay, it's the second time I mentioned cat, so the cat started looking at me. Then a man, it's the first time I say a man, tapped me on the shoulder. The man, second time, same man, asked me if the cat scared me. So there you can see, a cat becomes the cat the second time. A man becomes the man the second time. And this is something, if you haven't realized it before, now that I've pointed it out, you'll see it a lot when you're reading books in English. Let's move on to the showing common knowledge. To show the listener or reader that they know or will soon know what we are writing or talking about. Now it forces the listener or reader to think of the most obvious noun. Now this is a long explanation, but again, when you use the, you're expecting the listener or reader to understand what you're talking about. Now, can you pick up the book? Now, if someone said that, immediately your first reaction would be to look for the nearest book. It's probably right in front of you. Now, you, of course, you could say that book, absolutely. But again, you know, if there's one window in the room and someone says, oh, look out the window, right? We would say the window because we both, oh, there's a window and we can see it. So it's kind of, this one's a little bit confusing for learners because they're like, well, how do I know if it's a or the? Again, the speakers are using it or the writer is using it to show something that should be obvious. Now we're getting a little bit more technical, and we can use the to refer backwards or forwards in a text or conversation, okay? We already showed one example, which I'll go into again. It could also be used to indicate our shared or common knowledge. And, you know, shared or common knowledge, this could be like, do you like the new teacher? We both have the same teacher. There's only one, right? We know who it is. And that's why we'd say, do you like the new teacher? That's kind of the shared knowledge. Now, when we talk about referring backwards, it's the same example again, right? I was walking to school when I saw a cat. The cat, okay, is referring backwards to the first cat, started looking at me. Then a man tapped me on the shoulder. The man, referring back to the same man, asked if the cat scared me. So again, I just really want to emphasize this example, what it's doing. It's referring backwards. Now, referring forwards is much less common, okay? It does happen when you're reading, but it's much harder to use, okay? My example here is buy candy for the students who will win the contest, okay? So, you know, it's the first time we're talking about students, but again, later we say, oh, who will win? Like, we know there will be winners, and this is referring forwards. And also there's external reference. Should we go and talk to the teacher or the principal? Again, it's something we both know and we can assume. So we say the because we both know which teacher. Now moving on, there's no articles for generalizations. So let me show you what this means. No articles for plurals, i.e. grapes after dinner. So there's no there because again, we talked about earlier. A is one, right? So no plurals and no uncountable nouns. Money is very important. Again, we talked about this before, but it's good to make sure you understand. Now I'm going to move on to a few more very detailed rules. These are very specific rules, and this is for higher levels, you know, people who are going for a higher level of English, because they are very specific and they're based on certain nouns. So let me go into those now. The first one I'll go over is the for entertainment. I went to the cinema. I went to the pub. I went to the shops. I went to the mall. Okay. That's just what we say. It's often, you know, the for these things. Just, you know, don't worry too much about why, but when you're practicing or writing them down, just the mall, the shops. The for transport. I arrived at the airport. I arrived at the bus stop. I took the bus. I took the subway. Now, English can be pretty annoying because we do say, I took a taxi. I make the joke that, hey, I didn't invent English. I'm just teaching it, but that is the rule. Usually the for transport, but not always. Now, for musical instruments, we always say the. I play the piano. I play the violin. I play the guitar. And usually for common places in any town, we often say the. I went to the post office. I went to the hospital. Okay. But again, this one's not perfect. Okay. You could say, I went to, you know, a barbershop, or I went to the barbershop. Both are okay. So if you have a grammar book that tells you one is correct, they're not. English is changing. But in general, it is kind of a habit people have to say the hospital, even though a hospital is acceptable. Now, the must also go with rivers like the Nile, mountain ranges, not one mountain, but ranges, you know, many mountains, the Rockies, the Andes, oceans and seas, the Pacific, the Atlantic, deserts, the Sahara, the Mugavi, okay, groups of islands, the Maldives, okay, the Galapagos, hotels, the Hilton, the Ramada, cinemas, The Cinemax, the Odeon, political groups, the Democrats, the Republicans, newspapers, the New York Times. Okay, again, it's not always like this, but generally, all of those things have the in front of them. No articles for most time expressions. Next month, last year, on Monday, at the weekend. Oh no, we do say at the weekend with the in it. So again, it's not perfect, but we do say at the weekend, and usually there's no there's no articles for that. No articles for meals. I had breakfast. I will eat lunch later. Okay, so for meals, there's no the. No articles for work, home, or bed. I went to work. I came home. I went to bed. So that's it. No articles for proper nouns, like names. I will talk to Adam. We never say the Adam. And places, I went to Toronto. Okay, so again, there's no the in front of these kinds of nouns, and they're names of places and people. There are some exceptions, like I said earlier, like, you know, the names of like the Hilton, but again, usually like places like cities, towns, village, there's no the in front of them. And the final rule is idioms. Don't follow any rules. Sometimes there's an article, sometimes there's not. You just have to memorize them, the full idiom, as like one expression. So even though it might be four or five expressions, and you can see my idiom videos, but there's not really a rule to idioms. For example, we say in a hurry. That's it. We don't say in the hurry. Off the record. I mean, this is, you know, not official. Out of action. So you can see these are three different idioms. Sometimes they have the, sometimes they have a, sometimes they have nothing. You just have to study them as like one expression and not stress yourself with why there's an article or not an article. So I hope this lesson really helped a lot. I enjoyed preparing it. Even as a teacher, it's good to be really clear on all the rules for this, because, you know, there are a lot of rules around articles. Thank you very much for watching, and here's some more videos that you might be interested in. Please subscribe, please share it with people, as this would really help me a lot. Give it a thumbs up, add some comments, and I wish you the best of luck on your next IELTS test.